What would happen if you locked a bunch of engineers in a room for 6 years without any adult supervision? Well, the fine folks at Vault-Tec, I mean Dyson, have done just that, presenting the Dyson Zone headphones with air filters. Okay, so in theory, this would work great in a busy, polluted city. The problem is, without a seal between the clean air and your face, this isn't gonna work all that great. Interestingly enough, this unlisted video suggests that Dyson had an attachable face covering in mind for this product, with instructions and everything, but it never made it to the final product for some reason. Oh, and this might not be a great fit if you have a big nose like mine. Now, Dyson have said that these are first and foremost a set of headphones, and that's likely to preempt the shortcomings of the air filter. But at 3.1 pounds, including the carrying case, I'd say these are a little heavy for a headphones first approach. We'll come back to the weight of these things later in the teardown, but for now, check out these cool spinning fans. Dyson has a lot of experience with filtration systems, and we can see that at work here. The fan pulls the outside air through the filters, causing any particles and pollutants in the air to become trapped in the filter, while allowing the smaller air molecules to flow right through into the visor. It's not perfect, but the filters are supposedly able to catch 99% of pollutants as small as 0.1 micron in size. The first thing I want to do is to find and disconnect the battery, which I'll probably find inside the ear cups. Let's start by removing the metal filter plates, the filters, and the ear cushions. Underneath all that, I spot 6 of the 8 active noise cancellation microphones poking out. A theme throughout this teardown is going to be the top-end build quality. It's all very Dyson, everything from the smooth metal finish to the royal purple screams luxury. Back to the teardown. The replaceable filters sit on a plastic bracket that also encases the fan. Several Torx screws are holding it in place, and on closer inspection, I can see that the fan assembly is also stabilized with rubber grommets attached to this plastic casing. Vibration dampening without glue is a definite win in our books. Oh, what's this little button here for? The fan won't activate without a filter in place, and this switch sitting on top of a spring-loaded magnet is how the system knows the filter is loaded. The magnet probably interacts with a hole sensor behind the plastic. Still no battery, so let's turn the headphones over and try to get in from the driver's side. This seems to be the way in. A single flex cable allows me to detach the drivers completely. There's a fair amount packed in here, and it's definitely getting more complicated with all these flex cables all over the place. Before I know it, things turn ugly. I'm not able to remove any of the boards because of awkwardly placed ZIF connectors underneath the boards and soldered wires on 3 sides. Massive repair fail here. With the wires desoldered, I can finally remove the last of the filter mechanism, the brushless fan motors. The headphones with faceplate weigh in at about 1.46 pounds, or about 6 bananas for my metrically inclined brethren. It turns out that just over 0.5 pound can be attributed to the filtration system. That leaves the headphones at 0.93 pounds, much closer to the 0.85 pounds of the AirPods Max. Moving on to the next repairability fail, we've got C-clips securing the ear cups to the headband. While C-clips are compact, lightweight, and work just fine from a longevity standpoint, they aren't easy to remove or replace. With the ear cups apart, I can confidently say that I haven't found any batteries yet, so on to the headbands, because if they aren't here, then these are bloody well powered by dark magic. No witch burning today, folks. While I nearly broke my spudger getting in, there are 2 battery packs hidden in the headbands, each pack consisting of a twin-cell 4.89 watt-hour lithium polymer battery. That's nearly twice the capacity of the AirPods Max's 2.66 watt-hour batteries. And there it is, the filtration headphones from Dyson. I'm left with many questions. Will Dyson usher in a new trend of visored pedestrians? Will they ever release the face cover that would have allowed the filtration system to work properly? And how long is it going to be before this ends up in the back of your closet and you completely forget you had it? One thing I know for sure, this $1,000 headset is not user serviceable. From multiple soldered wires to very difficult to detach battery packs, the Dyson Zone presents a very intimidating repair challenge to anyone.